Hello, in this video we will talk about how to connect your TELETASK iSGUI app to your central unit using the TELETASK Cloud. This of course requires that your system integrator has already connected your installation to the TELETASK Cloud. For more information on that, contact your system integrator. When system integrator has added you as an end user to a TELETASK Cloud connected installation, you will receive a mail with an invitation to the TELETASK Cloud. These kind of mails sometimes end up in spam folders, so if you don't receive the mail, please check your spam folder to see if the email isn't in there. So this is the mail I've received from the TELETASK Cloud with an invitation to register. So I can see here that I've added to the installation called demo case by my system integrator Nils Spers. So I can click this link to create a TELETASK Cloud account for me. So, I will fill in some details. Now remember, long passwords are much more secure than short passwords, but I'll use an easy password for the demo because you will see me using this password later in this video. So, I agree to some things and then click register. Thank you. So we've now registered, but we still need to confirm our email address. So if I head back to my inbox, I will see that I have a new email. So I click this link to activate my account. And my account has been activated. And now I will be forwarded to the homepage of the cloud. And now I can see that I have a location. It's called demo case. It's owned by me. And the system integrator is Nils Bergs. Before we take a look at the rest of the possibilities of the TELETASK Cloud website, we will first show you how to use iSGUI. So here you see the iSGUI. As this one, the first time it's start up. Note that I'm connected using 4G. And I'm also using iSGUI version 2.6. So let's click setup. And then it asks us whether we want to set up a cloud or a local location. Of course, we could choose for a cloud location. Enter our email address. And then our password. Now remember, don't use this password, use a secure password. Now it's loading the cloud locations, so it's communicating with the TELETASK Cloud servers. It has found the location and now it is connected. So without entering an IP address, I'm connected to a central unit. And now let's see if we can control something. So we go to the living room and there you can see I have my dimmers, my devices and some other things. And then I can change the value of a dimmer, control a device, change the radio, for example, or I can even control or see the camera. And there we have a car moving on the screen. So as you can see, very easy setup for the TELETASK Cloud connected iSGUI. Back to the TELETASK Cloud website. So we told already earlier that we see the locations here on the left. So we have one location demo case. If I click this link, I can see the details of my installation. The first thing you notice is that there's a message here that my system integrator has full access, so he can do user management and use iSGUI on my location. And I can change this if I want to. Both things have advantages. It's an advantage if your system integrator has full access, because then he can provide some services in case there is a problem or in case you don't know how to operate something, things like that. Or if you need to change a user and you don't want to do it yourself, you want your system integrator to do it, he can do it for you using the TELETASK Cloud then. On the other hand, for privacy reasons, you might say, no, I don't want my system integrator to have access to my iSGUI and to my user management. Now, you can easily change this if you go to the to the System Integrators tab, you can see that the System Integrator has full access now. I can simply change this here to no access, and then the System Integrator can't see anything on the TELETASK Cloud from my installation, and he can't use his iSGUI to connect to my installation. In the Users tab, we can see an overview of all the users that are added to the system. Currently, there's only one user added to the system, and that's me, and I have a proximity card. I can edit this user. For example, suppose that I've lost my proximity card and I got a new one, and I want to change the card number. So I just take the card, look at what number that there's written on the card, and then I enter this number here. So if this is the new number, I add this number, and I can simply save this. Now this information is synchronized with the central unit. It should work within a minute. I can also add a user here, so if I click add user, of course I need to give the user a name. Let's add a user, for example. Cloud account. Now if I want this user to be able to connect to the TELETASK Cloud to use the iSGUI app, I must provide an email address for this user. So let's create some email address. Now, this user will also receive an invitation mail for the TELETASK Cloud. Then she has to click on the mail, fill in the details, and confirm her email address. Now that I've given the user an email address, I can provide a role for the cloud. If I make a user a regular user, she has access to the iSGUI, but she can't add other users or edit users. But if I make her owner, she can also add other users, use her iSGUI. So basically the same as I can do. Let's make her owner. If you have a proximity reader, again, you can provide a number here for the proximity tag or the proximity card, and then some other settings related to access control. I won't go into detail. If you now save this user will be added to the TELETASK Cloud, an invitation mail will be sent, will be synchronized with the central unit, all those kinds of things. But for now, I will just cancel it. Final tab is the devices. Here you can see a list of all the devices. In this case, we can see that I've already used two devices to connect to my central unit using iSGUI app, an Android and an iPad. I can block these devices here. Suppose that a device gets stolen or lost or whatever, you can block that device here. So even if somebody has access to your device, they know your PIN code, for example, if the device is blocked here, they can't connect to the TELETASK Cloud with that device. If you want to add the device again because you found it, you can simply log into the device again in the iSGUI app, and it will appear again in this list. In this list, you will see devices from all users, so not only from yourself, but from all users. If you're looking for a specific device of yourself, you can also use this link, your devices, and here you can only see the devices that you have used to connect to this or another installation. And then there's a little help menu here that will explain some more things about how to add a user, how to edit a user, how to change your password, for example. So some basic help is integrated right into the website. I think this concludes our tutorial. If you still have any questions about the TELETASK Cloud, contact your system integrator. Thank you for watching, and enjoy using the TELETASK Cloud.